Hello everyone, I just performed and saw magic by the amazing and legendary Johnny Thompson. Now, I was invited to my friend's house that I know from school. His father is actually a magician and really good friends with Johnny Thompson, and he flew down here and went to his house. And since his father is a magician and I'm a magician, I asked if it was okay by my friend if I'd come over and see Johnny perform. And Johnny is just an amazing guy. He is, without a doubt, the best sleight of hand artist I have ever seen, whether it be in live performance or on video. This guy's moves were just absolutely clean. He has like the cleanest pass I've ever seen. I know it's happening, but I just can't. The guy's amazing. So I did get the chance to perform some effects from him. Of course, just like the Wayne Housen thing, when I met Wayne Housen and performed for him, I was a little nervous. If you haven't seen that video yet, I'll post a link in the post a link right here, actually. Right here, I don't know if you can see this over here, but I'll post a link so you can actually view that video if you haven't seen it. But I performed for Johnny Thompson and it was awesome. Not the best performance, but hey, it works. There's some other stuff. I'll post another link over here to a different video of Johnny Thompson performing. Now, I did get a little bit of performances by Johnny. There's some footage I won't put up because he actually did teach us some stuff. And just for out of respect for the trick, the creator, and of course, respect for Johnny, I'm not going to put those explanations up for obvious reasons. But I will put up some performances. He is really, really amazing, talented guy, and a down-to-earth guy. He's just such a cool guy. Also, I was performing for a room full of magicians, and yeah, so that might explain why there wasn't too much reactions, but I mean, it's magicians, so what can you expect? So, without further ado, here is a video of me performing to Johnny Thompson. Check it out. And what you do is touch one card. This one right here? Are you sure you want this one?
Yeah, sure.
Are you sure? No, I'll give you a chance to change your mind.
No.
You got it? Alright, my hand's a little sweaty, so it's sticking. I also have a Sharpie right over here, so just sign your name real big across it.
Okay.
It's your bowling ball.
Alright, cool, cool. Try that so you can see that. Actually, are you left-handed or right-handed?
Right-handed.
Hold it right hand, flat like this. And go ahead and place your other hand on top of it, just like that. Okay. Can I actually use you?
Sure.
Can you actually take the lighter and light it for me?
Okay.
Okay, great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the Joker. We're just going to take it. I'm just going to light and just kind of burn the back. I'm not going to light it on fire. I'm just going to put a little black mark on it.
Check the smoke on.
Hopefully. There we go. Yeah, that's good. Now, hopefully, I don't want to burn you, so hopefully, that's not too hot, right?
No, but it's warm.
Okay. What I want you to do is think of the Joker cooling off.
Yeah.
Okay? And I want you to think of the card that you chose. That's in between your hands, heating up in your hands. Okay? Just imagine that in your hands, okay? You got that? Watch. Just snap, hopefully. Right there. Now that card's been in between your hands. Go ahead and turn it over the back.
Ah.
That's great.
I just need you. Sure. Two red kings. Here we go. Alright. Now, this is a kind of a two-phased routine, okay? What you do is choose any card you want. It doesn't matter which one it is. I don't want to look at it. You can show the camera as well.
All right.
Okay?
Yes.
All right. Place it back in.
Okay.
Just make sure it really is your card.
Yes.
Okay? And you remember your card, right?
Yes.
Okay. This is what's going to happen. Actually, let me shuffle it back up, I think. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place one king on top. Actually, you check them out. Like they are normal kings, right?
Yes, they are.
Okay, just make sure. So one king goes on top,
Mm-hmm. One king of swords goes on the bottom, right?
Yeah.
Just think about your card. You remember your card, correct?
Yeah.
Just think about yours, okay? Watch. One, two, three. Hopefully. Should be.
The ace of hearts, absolutely correct.
Now, like I said, this is a two-faced thing.
Okay.
So what I'm going to try to do, we'll use the exact same card. So we'll place your card, go and take your card and place it back in. Now, about how many cards would you say your card is for the top?
I would say it's roughly about 24 cards.
24, okay. Watch, let's see if I can do this. Okay, I'm going to take the two kings. I'm going to place one near the top. I'm going to place one near the bottom, just like this, okay? Now, what's interesting about this, because the first time I did it, I was all, you know, it was me holding the deck.
Yes.
So, of course, it had to be some sort of sleight of hand technique. I'm going to try to do this as fair as possible. In fact, you are going to do this, okay? So you take the deck. And yes. I want you to cut the deck of cards in half. Just like that. And
complete the cut.
Okay. Okay? Now, when you did that, the two kings went down in the deck a little bit, eliminating some of the cards in the way. Just like this. So goes down. But there is a little bit of mess in here, okay? So we're going to try this one more time. Okay. Now, about how many cards should you say is in between the two kings?
Well, it looks to me like six cards.
Okay.
We don't maybe need seven.
Six or seven? Okay.
Yeah.
We don't need those. And just like last time, take the packet and cut it in half and complete the cut.
Okay.
And go ahead and pick it up. I'm not going to do anything strange.
Mm-hmm.
You remember your card, right?
Yes.
Okay. Hopefully. Spread to those two kings. One card in between. And you cut the packet anywhere you wanted, right?
And it's my card. Very nice.
Yeah, very nice.
Very nice.